We are doing this video today to explain what are the basic cricket equipment one needs to start playing the sport. There is a lot of confusion as to what all cricket equipment is needed to play hardball cricket, or as we call it, leather ball cricket. So let's get right into it. So the first piece of equipment and the most important thing that is needed for the game of cricket, at least when concerned from the point of view of a batsman, is the cricket bat. Each of these bats is made with a Kashmir willow or a handcrafted English willow. The Kashmir willow is used in the Indian subcontinent, whereas the handcrafted English willow is mostly used in the club cricket levels right up to the international cricket levels. Ideally, a bat would last you about a year if you have 2 games a week, but it's based on how good you maintain it. As you can see, I have 2 of these bats and they've been going pretty well for a year now. About the dimensions of the cricket bat. A bat cannot be longer than 38 inches in length, and as far as the width is concerned, it cannot be wider than 4.25 inches. The cricket law requires the bat to be made out of wood only. These things were first introduced in 1624, and as you can see, they have come a long way. Okay, so let's now talk about the cricket balls. As you can see, I have a white cricket ball as well as a red cricket ball in my hand here. The red cricket ball is used for test cricket, or typically the longer format of the game, which is a 2-day cricket or 5-day cricket, whereas the white cricket ball is used for the shorter format, typically T20s or 50 over games. The circumference of the ball is typically between 8.8 to 9 inches, whereas the weight of the ball is between 5.5 to 5.75 ounces. This piece of protection equipment is called a thigh guard. It is strapped around your thigh and your hip. A right-handed batsman would wear this on his left thigh, and a left-handed batsman would wear it on his right thigh. Nowadays, you get combination thigh guards which help protect your inner leg as well as your outer leg for better protection. This is the abdominal guard, or as people call it, the L guard or the box. It is used to protect the genital area. The biggest piece of protection equipment in cricket in terms of size is the leg guard, or as people generally refer to them as the pads. The pads are worn in the front part of your legs to protect your ankles right up to your thighs. They are worn on both legs and they are either 2-strapped or 3-strapped. One has to make sure that these pads are thick enough so they can protect impact from a ball traveling between 80 to 100 miles an hour while batting, whereas also making sure that these pads are light enough to enable the batsman to run comfortably between the wickets to score runs, which is one of the ways in which runs are made in the game of cricket. This is a pair of cricket batting gloves. They are used by the batsman to protect against a possible impact with the ball while batting. They also help the batsman grip the bat firmly while he's batting. Cricket, like most of the ball games, is a game of contact. And here, the contact between the bat and the ball is essential, and this is enabled by the batsman's firm grip to the bat. Generally, these gloves are made out of leather on the inner palms to enable better grip with the bat. On the outer side, they use some sort of synthetic fibers since they are light and also provide protection to the fingers. This keeps these gloves lightweight. A professional cricketer would carry at least a couple of these in his kit bag. According to many, the most important piece of protection equipment in modern day cricket would be the batsman's helmet. This helmet typically weighs between 1 to 2 pounds and comes in different sizes. The helmet also comes with a notch at the back, which helps to tighten it and keep it in its place and avoid wobbling around while the batsman is running between the wickets. If you also notice, there is a gap between the grill and the top part of the helmet. This helps keep a clear line of sight with the ball. Fun fact here, the helmet was invented about 100 years after the L guard was invented. The last piece of protection equipment we'll be talking about today is the elbow guard. The elbow guard is used to protect your arm and your elbow, and it is typically strapped using a 2-strap method around your arm in this fashion. All of the cricket equipment that we use today could be packed and carried around using this cricket kit bag.
Hey guys, thanks for checking out the first episode of the Cricketer series. If you're interested in more videos like this, you can check out our I Am Naidu channel and subscribe. And if you're interested in this high quality equipment that we've shown in this video, you can find affordable prices at the website of asusanow.com. The link will be down in our description below. And if you're interested in more of the Cricketer series, go check out our I Am Naidu channel and go ahead and subscribe for more of the Cricketer series. Thanks for watching.